You may have heard that type 2 diabetes can't be cured, that diabetes never goes away, and that a life of medication and struggling to maintain balance is the only option. Well, people get high insulin due to insulin resistance, which has a domino effect, a cycle of blood sugar imbalance, and a havoc throughout the body. But according to the 2017 paper entitled Beating Type 2 Diabetes into Remission, with biochemical remission of type 2 diabetes, beta cell function in the pancreas may improve, leading to better insulin control, effectively reversing diabetes. So today we're going to explore 11 simple tips for reversing diabetes, including superfoods that will help make the journey easier, giving you the knowledge you need to support a healthy pancreas, liver, and gut, so that your body is naturally optimized and running efficiently. Plus, we'll share a quick end-of-the-day checklist to help you sleep well, have more energy, and stay on track. But before we get into it, can you do us a favor and like this video? Ring the bell for future notifications and make sure you subscribe to Diabetics Talk for more practical diabetes information. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get not one, not two, but three free gifts. Also, don't forget to check out exclusive Diabetics Talk merchandise from our store and sign up as a member to get full access to the Food, Health, and You Complete Implementation System documentary and more. Okay, let's get into it. Number 11, monitor your blood sugar. If you have diabetes, monitoring your blood sugar is essential. First and foremost, monitoring helps you understand how different foods and activities affect your blood sugar levels. This is important because different people react differently. For example, Bob may find that sweet potatoes cause his blood sugar to spike, while Jane doesn't have the same reaction. By monitoring your blood sugar, you can learn how your body responds and make adjustments. You can identify trends and build on your progress. Journaling can also help to identify things that help you stay on track. For example, prepping meals on the weekend may lead to a great week, or maybe a certain type of physical activity is especially effective at lowering your blood sugar. Identifying and repeating success is key to reversing diabetes. Journaling is particularly useful for tracking HbA1c results over time. HbA1c is a measure of your average blood sugar level over the past 2 to 3 months. Writing it down gives a clear picture of how well your diabetes management plan is working over time. To summarize, if you want to reverse diabetes, it's important to understand how your body responds to different stimuli. Monitoring and tracking your progress is key. Number 10, stay hydrated. Hydration is crucial for many functions, including blood sugar balance. Water flushes excess glucose out of the body, which means lower blood sugar levels. Being properly hydrated can also help improve insulin sensitivity. High blood sugar puts pressure on the kidneys, which creates more urine to expel the glucose. This can lead to dehydration in tissues, so it's vitally important to replace those fluids by drinking plenty of water. Finally, staying hydrated can help with weight management. Water can help fill you up and aids digestion, which is helpful if you need to lose weight. The general guideline is to aim for 8 glasses of water per day, although this varies depending on age, sex, size, and activity levels. So talk to your doctor about the amount that is perfect for you. Number 9, get enough magnesium. Magnesium is an essential mineral that many people don't get enough of. It's involved in muscle function, nerve function, and bone health. It is also important for maintaining healthy insulin function and blood sugar balance. Good sources of magnesium include bananas, nuts, beans, leafy greens, and fatty fish. So be sure to include these in your meal planning and keep your magnesium topped up. Number 8, sunshine. Sunshine generates vitamin D, which is important for maintaining healthy blood sugar levels. Vitamin D is involved in insulin production and may help improve insulin sensitivity. Low levels of vitamin D have been linked to an increased risk of type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular disease, heart attack, and stroke. In fact, a study published in the Journal of Endocrinology and Metabolism found that people with insufficient vitamin D had a 500% increased risk of sudden cardiac death. Sun exposure improves the melatonin system, which impacts insulin function. Scientists believe that sun exposure improves artery health by protecting the endothelial lining, which has knock-on benefits for heart and blood health. And of course, it's important to protect your skin from sun damage. Limit your time in the sun and avoid the hottest part of the day while still getting some exposure. Number 7, move your body. Regular physical activity is vital to managing or reversing diabetes. In the short term, exercise lowers blood sugar by increasing the uptake of glucose by the muscles. When you exercise, your muscles use more glucose, which lowers your blood sugar levels. You are literally burning glucose. In the long term, regular exercise can also improve the body's sensitivity to insulin. Aim for at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity or 75 minutes of vigorous intensity exercise per week. Start slowly and gradually increase the intensity and duration of your workouts. Ideally, include a mix of cardiovascular exercise such as walking, running, or cycling, as well as strength training such as lifting weights or using resistance bands. Strength training tears muscle fibers, and as those fibers rebuild, we get stronger. This process requires significantly more glucose than aerobic exercise. In fact, a 2018 study found that women engaging in any strength training experienced a reduced rate of type 2 diabetes of 30%. And if you're not excited by the idea of strength training, we have good news. Another study found that moderate paced walk after eating led to a 12% reduction of blood glucose levels versus walking at other times, meaning that walking after a meal is an excellent option if you want to stay on top of diabetes. Whatever you choose, the key takeaway is to move your body. Whether it's weightlifting, running, yoga, dancing, or a regular walk, just do it. Number 6, quit smoking. Smoking is a major risk factor for diabetes and heart disease. People with diabetes are more likely to develop heart disease than those without diabetes, and smoking increases this risk even further. Smoking damages the blood vessels and can lead to plaque buildup in the arteries, which can cause heart attacks and strokes. It also increases blood pressure and heart rate, further straining the cardiovascular system. It is never too late to quit smoking and make positive changes to improve your health. Before we get to number 5, how about those free gifts? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free Diabetes Fighting documentary. Plus, get a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 delicious and easy-to-prepare recipes that the whole family will love. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. Now back to our video. Number 5, avoid excess alcohol. Excess alcohol can worsen the symptoms of diabetes. It is important to limit alcohol intake in order to maintain good blood sugar control and prevent complications. First, set limits for yourself. It's recommended that men have no more than 2 drinks per day and women have no more than 1 drink per day. 1 drink is equivalent to 12 ounces of beer, 5 ounces of wine, or 1.5 ounces of hard liquor. It's also best to choose low carb options. Some types of alcohol, such as beer and sweet cocktails, are high in carbohydrates and can cause a spike in blood sugar. Choosing lower carb options such as vodka or gin mixed with soda water and a squeeze of lemon or lime can help to minimize the impact on blood sugar. If you're going to drink, make sure to eat as well. Having food in your stomach can help to slow the absorption of alcohol and minimize its impact on blood sugar. Number four, eat whole foods. Eating whole foods is an essential part of reversing diabetes. Whole foods are nutrient dense, providing a wide range of essential vitamins, minerals, and fiber without added sugars, salts, and chemical additives. Vegetables should be the foundation of any diet due to their high nutritional value and low sugar content. A few of the best whole foods for diabetics include leafy greens. Leafy greens are low in calories and carbohydrates and high in fiber. Spinach, kale, and arugula also contain important vitamins and minerals, including vitamins A, C, and K, potassium, and folate. Cruciferous vegetables. Vegetables like broccoli, cauliflower, and Brussels sprouts are incredibly important for artery health. They contain important compounds, sulforaphane, vitamin K, and folate, all of which have been linked to a reduced risk of diabetes and heart attack and promote healthy blood. Nuts and seeds. These foods are a good source of healthy fats, which help to slow the absorption of sugar in the bloodstream. The monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats in nuts and seeds are linked to reduced risk of heart disease, improved cognitive function, reduced inflammation, and healthy weight management. Colorful fruits and vegetables. Colorful plants are packed with compounds like anthocyanins and carotenoids, which have potent health benefits. They protect against oxidative damage, improve blood sugar control, and protect against eye damage, a common complication of diabetes. So look for more opportunities to eat more brightly colored foods like beetroot, bell peppers, berries, carrots, and kiwi fruit. Number three, cut refined carbohydrates and toxic foods. Refined carbs cause spikes in blood sugar levels and keep the diabetes cycle going. These types of foods include white bread, pasta, and processed cereals, all products made from white flour, which has been stripped of most nutrients during the refining process. It's best to avoid these items as much as possible, or at least reduce them significantly if you want to get your blood sugar under control. Instead, opt for whole grain alternatives such as oats and quinoa, which are higher in fiber, meaning they break down more slowly into glucose. Other toxic foods to cut are processed foods, sugary drinks, and trans fats. These foods are a disaster for diabetics. They cause oxidation of blood vessels and completely disrupt hormone regulation, which leads to a domino effect of problems that destroy any chance of reversing diabetes. Number two, spices. Spices are one of the best things you can eat more of if you have diabetes or want to prevent it. They're packed with antioxidants, which help fight inflammation and oxidative stress in the body, both of which play a role in the development of diabetes and its complications. Additionally, some spices can directly help lower blood sugar levels by increasing insulin sensitivity and decreasing glucose absorption from food. Some specific spices that may be beneficial for reversing diabetes include cinnamon, ginger, turmeric, garlic, cumin, and black pepper. Cinnamon has been found to improve fasting blood glucose levels, as well as decrease LDL, or bad, cholesterol, and increase HDL, the good, cholesterol, all helpful for managing type 2 diabetes symptoms. Ginger helps reduce post-meal spikes in blood sugar resulting from carbohydrate-rich meals, while turmeric is believed to improve pancreatic cell function. Garlic can help regulate your digestive system, aiding digestion, while cumin stimulates the release of bile acids into the intestines, allowing better absorption of nutrients. This may help to prevent spikes in blood sugar after meals when eaten regularly over time. Lastly, black pepper contains piperine, which increases circulation throughout the body. Piperine also has anti-inflammatory properties, which protect against complications such as heart disease and kidney damage. And number one, reduce stress. Stress has a huge impact on diabetes, both directly and indirectly. While we're under stress, our body produces the hormones cortisol and epinephrine, which cause our blood glucose levels to rise. In fact, studies show that eating while stressed may lead to an abnormal glucose response, meaning that even if you're eating the right foods and doing other things right, stress can interfere with your body's ability to repair itself. In addition, prolonged periods of stress can make us less likely to take care of ourselves properly by eating healthy foods and exercising regularly. Likewise, insufficient sleep is linked to increased diabetes and related complications. So it's vitally important to think about your sleep habits and create a daily routine that takes care of your sleep and mental health. Regular exercise and healthy foods are going to help, and you may want to think about other aspects, such as yoga, meditation, or other practices, spending time with people who lift you up, and dedicating time to hobbies and having fun. Finally, set yourself up for success when it comes to sleep. At minimum, establish consistent bedtime and wake-up times. Avoid caffeine late in the day and make sure your bedroom is cool, dark, and quiet. Think about anything else that helps you relax and wind down at the end of the day. While these may sound like trivial steps, they can make an enormous difference to your stress levels, and they can transform your body's efficiency when it comes to hormone balance, sleep, fat burning, insulin, and blood glucose control. There you have it, 11 simple tips to reverse diabetes. Monitor your blood sugar, stay hydrated, get enough magnesium, sunshine, move your body, quit smoking, avoid excess alcohol, eat whole foods, cut refined carbohydrates and toxic foods, spices, and reduce stress. We hope these help you. And now we want to hear from you. What habits, routines, tricks, and tips help you? Share them with the community in the comments below. It may just help a fellow diabetic who is searching for solutions. And make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button. And don't forget, you can claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. We want to keep making informative, research-based videos for you. So if you gained value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. We're Diabetics Talk, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight obesity and diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.